Another loaded show coming your way here on Golden State Warriors today, but another reminder to subscribe to the channel. A little more than 400 people away from 47,000 subscribers. Trade deadline is coming up on February 9th, by the way, so we're going to continue to ramp up our coverage here on Warriors today. So it's a great opportunity for you to subscribe, and let's hit that number by the end of January. Otherwise, the bosses might fire me. I'm just kidding. I don't think I'm going to get fired. We're just asking you to help us out and subscribe to the channel because this is the go-to spot for all of the best Warriors coverage. And coming your way on today's show, going to open up the floor here and just take some of your questions about what you think about the Warriors, maybe some trade assets they could look to target to improve this roster to try to win back-to-back NBA championships. And speaking of some of our subscribers, Marquise Robertson, a big one, no doubt, comes in with this one. Do you see the Golden State Warriors trading for Zach LaVine or Alex Caruso? Obviously, two different players in terms of their game, two different players in terms of how much they cost. Zach LaVine on the max, Alex Caruso very affordable, Alex Caruso defensive heavy, Zach LaVine offensive heavy. I do not think the Warriors are going to make a trade for Zach LaVine there, Marquise, but he's a really good player. I have some concerns about how the knee is going to age because those knee injury issues have been a problem of late. Now, the last four seasons, you were looking at a hyper athlete who was scoring the basketball at elite levels, 25 points per game. The shooting numbers, considering the volume and field goal attempts, pretty good at 47.5%, 39%. This year, numbers have gone down a little bit as the Bulls have also gone down compared to their start last year when they were one of the better teams in the Eastern Conference before injuries just ravaged them, especially to a guy like Lonzo Ball. But now he's averaging sub 23 points per game. I don't really care about the rebounds and the assists for him because that's not his game. Field goal numbers down from 47.5 to sub 46, 3-point, 39.2 to 38. So some concerns just with the athleticism here. I think that he's still a really good offensive player. I think that Caruso is much more realistic than Zach LaVine. And I think if the Warriors want to upgrade this defense and they're not happy with what Dante DiVincenzo gives them, or a guy like JaMychal Green, and they want to bolster their defense, and bringing in a guy like Alex Caruso could help them do that. And his stats in Chicago as a whole, not just this year, not just last year, you get a guy who's a pest, a guy who's not afraid to guard anybody at the NBA level. 6.5 points per game, 41-plus percent from the field, nearly 36% from downtown. I would like Caruso's fit on this roster. There's no doubt about that. So what do you think? Do the Warriors even need to make a trade? Because, of course, we're talking some trade rumors and trade buzz on today's show. Y for yes, N for no. Get those comments popping. The deadly claws. Do you think that Jordan Poole will win sixth man of the year? I don't think so, because actually Jordan Poole this year has had a down year as compared to last year. Now you pay him that money and you're expecting him to really duplicate what he did last year. And I understand that the betting odds, are what they are, with Russell Westbrook leading the charge at plus 125. Jordan Poole, second best odds at plus 325. I think this is more of a byproduct of this not being as strong of a race this year. Malcolm Brogdon, great year for the Celtics. Benedict Mathurin, arguably the best rookie so far this year in that 2022 NBA draft class. And then Norman Powell, 12-1. But Poole just has to get a little bit better. And when you look at what he's doing right now alongside Russell Westbrook, better player, and the numbers have gotten a little bit better for Jordan Poole, but you see the three-point numbers. I mean, they're pretty paltry at less than 31%, 43% from the deck. 20.5 points per game is good, and maybe he could win this award solely because of that. I just want to see Jordan Poole make some improvements. Hopefully he watches the show and he gets some source of motivation to do just that. You know what I'm motivated to do? Save money and cancel unnecessary subscriptions. That was on my list of things to do prior to the end of 2022, and I did it with Rocket Money. You can do the same. Cancel those unnecessary subscriptions today with this free and easy-to-use app. Do you know how much your subscriptions really cost? Well, most Americans think they spend about $80 per month on subscriptions when the actual total cost closer to 200 plus. That's right. You could be wasting hundreds of dollars each month on subscriptions you don't even know about. There's this app I love using. Takes care of that for me. It's called Rocket Money, formerly known as Truebill. Shows you all of your subscriptions in one place, cancels for you whatever you don't still want, and Rocket Money can even find subscriptions you didn't know you were paying for that you didn't know you signed up for. You may even find out you've been double charged, and all you have to do on the app is hit that cancel button. So it's rocketmoney.com/NBA now. Make sure you use that link so that they know that Chat Sports sent you. Cutter's highlights. Do you think that PBJ will get more minutes as the season goes on? I think that he played really well against the Jazz. Patrick Baldwin Jr. is who we're talking about here, just to clarify. And Patrick Baldwin Jr. is a solid player. Like, this guy going into college last year was looked at as one of the best recruits in the country. It didn't work out to fruition because he was injured a lot. I think there was COVID that entered the equation as well, and the team around him wasn't really picking him up, and because of that, he started to struggle. But we've seen some signs of life for PBJ. Great nickname, by the way. You mentioned that Jazz game back on the 28th when he played 12 and a half minutes, 11 points, 4 of 7, 3 of 5 from 3. If he continues to knock down three-pointers at this clip, that's a great sign. An even better game there on December 21st against Brooklyn when he dropped 17 and 23 minutes per game. When he's had some minutes, he's been able to perform pretty well. That game against the Knicks, it is what it is, but that's when the Warriors just got throttled. But I'm a believer in him. Length, shooting, athleticism. His dad was a basketball coach, so he's a heady, smart basketball player. Maybe he could get some more minutes, but it's hard to crack the rotation on this type of roster. Big Baller Barry, triple B's. How much would it cost the Warriors to pull off a trade for Bradley Beal? Maybe Draymond, Kuminga, Poole, and picks. It's pretty interesting here. So let me try to think about this really quickly. If you're Washington, do you want an old Draymond Green? I mean, you get young players in Kuminga and Poole, and Poole on a bad team, I'm not even kidding, he could average 25 to 30 points per game with more shot opportunities. I do think that Kuminga is still going to be a good player. I believe in him, although his season this year has been a little bit Jekyll and Hyde. But it might take more for Washington. If you throw James Wiseman in there, who didn't play on Tuesday night, maybe that could persuade them. For Bradley Beal coming to the Warriors, 23.5 points per game this year, chucking it up nearly 17 times, 53% from the field, which is good. Really sweet mid-range game, three-point numbers, solid, 34+. So Beal's a good player. I don't think the Warriors are going to trade for him, though. Wave Mob, I think the Warriors have their next dynasty in Baldwin, Moody, Kuminga, Wiseman, and Poole with or without a 40-plus-year-old Curry. That group will carry the torch. What do you think? Trade talks of Caruso, LaVine, Turner, and the likes are not necessary. I would simmer and marinate that group for the future. I love how you finished off that little note there. Simmer and marinate. That's fantastic. So I'm not going to go as far as to say it's the next dynasty, but I got done complimenting Baldwin. Moses Moody, if he were on a bad team getting more minutes, he could be a pretty solid three-point shooter. Like to see him be a little bit less streaky, but when he's given opportunities, we saw last year during his rookie campaign, he was good. Jonathan Kuminga is an athletic freak who has elite two-way potential. I still think that Wiseman could be a good player. I just don't know if it's going to happen with the Warriors. And then with the 40-plus-year-old Steph Curry, man, that sounds crazy to say. He could be like his pops, Del Curry. When he was playing with the Raptors in the 2001 Eastern Conference semifinals with Vince Carter against the Sixers, he was making a rain. He played well. And Curry can really extend his career by just being that three-point specialist. So who has the brightest future among the four there that we just discussed? Moses Moody, James Wiseman, Jonathan Kuminga, or PBJ? Let us know in the comment section. Our guy Chualor, how can the Warriors stop turning the ball over and stop fouling to give the other team a chance to win? They just have to be a little bit more smart with their defensive tenacity, and the Warriors are a team that really does like to increase their defensive intensity. But sometimes, you know, they get a little bit wacky. The arms get out of control. You start reaching a little bit. But they'll be fine, Chualor. This is a very well-coached basketball team. Do want to give shout-outs to some of our most recent subscribers. Thanks to you for continuing to support the channel. Barraza Fam, Happy Cartoons 1000, Slick Moo Boo, as well as Moises Ferreira. Appreciate all of you for subscribing to the show. You subscribe. That means you're a real one. And if you're still watching the show, that too means you're a real one. So comment real one. Dub Nation, we thank you so much for watching today's show, and we'll catch you next time here on Warriors Today.